Praise the name of the Lord. God bless everyone that have joined this prayer line. I know the God that you serve will surely answer in the name of Jesus. Let's open our mouth as we bless the name of the Lord in this song. Thank you, Jesus. I am grateful, O Lord. Hallelujah, I am grateful. Oh Lord, hallelujah, for all you have done for me. Hallelujah, I am grateful, oh Lord. Let's sing it loud and clear. I am grateful, oh Lord. Hallelujah, I am grateful, oh Lord. Hallelujah, for all you have done for me. Hallelujah, I am grateful, oh Lord, you have been so good. You are so good to us, oh Lord, you are excellent in our lives every day. Oh Lord, you have been so good. You are so good to us. Oh Lord, you are excellent in our lives. Let's sing it now. Oh Lord, you have been so good. You are so good to us. Oh Lord, you are excellent in our lives every day. Oh Lord, you have been so good. You are so good to us, oh Lord, you are excellent in our lives. Blessed be thy name, oh Lord, hallelujah. Blessed be thy name, oh Lord, in heaven and on earth. Blessed be thy name, in heaven and on earth. Hallelujah. Blessed be thy name. Let's sing it now. Blessed be thy name, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be thy name, oh Lord, in heaven and on earth. Hallelujah. Blessed be thy name, in heaven and on earth. Oh yes, blessed be thy name. Honor to your name, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Honor to your name, oh Lord, in heaven and on earth. Hallelujah. Honor to your name, in heaven and on earth. Honor to your name. Thank you, Jesus. Let's open our mouth and thank the Lord God Almighty, the Lord that has made us to see another time, even together on this prayer line. Say, Father, we bless your name. Our Lord, we give you praise. King of glory, we thank you for your love upon our lives. Yes, go ahead and thank the Lord. Thank him, the one that has made you to see even this very hour. Our Father, we thank you, Lord, for your love upon each and every one of us, for our families, for our husbands, for our wives, for our children, our brothers and sisters, our parents. We thank you for how you have kept everyone. We thank you for keeping us. We thank you for your love upon our lives. We worship your name, O Lord. I thank you for everyone connected to this prayer line. I thank you for your love upon their lives. I thank you for testimonies in their lives. I thank you for answering their prayers. I thank you, Almighty, for giving them a reason to also seek you. I thank you for giving them confidence to be with you, to Almighty know that you are their God. I thank you, Lord Almighty, that the devil has not sniffed them. I thank you because you have lifted up their head above their enemies that are round about them. I thank you, you have delivered them. You have kept them in your shadow. I bless your name. I thank you for your love. I thank you for your protection over their lives, over their going out and coming in. I say thank you, Jesus, for each and every one of us. We thank you, Lord, for your love, for provision, for your guidance, for your protection. protection, for Almighty, even the gift of life, that it will bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The word of God says, if we regard iniquity in our heart, that the Lord will not hear us. And the Bible says, if we confess our sins, it is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let's go ahead and begin to tell the Lord, Lord, have mercy. In your own words, tell the Lord, forgive me my sins. Every sin we have committed, both known and unknown sins, Lord, have mercy. Oh, Lord, as we are connected on this prayer line, we ask that you forgive us individually and collectively. Every sin that we've committed, oh, Lord, we ask whether conscious and unconscious sin. Lord, have mercy. Let your blood begin to prevail right now. Let your blood begin to move on our behalf. Let your blood, Almighty, begin to wash us from our iniquities and from our sins. Let your blood begin to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's open our mouth and take prayers and say, oh God, my Father, manifest yourself in our gathering. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, manifest yourself in our gathering in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, manifest yourself in this gathering in the name of Jesus. As you manifested yourself in the camp of the Israelites, that you manifest yourself in our camp today in the name of Jesus. Manifest yourself to everyone connected to this prayer line in the name of Jesus. That they manifest yourself in their families. Manifest yourself in their various homes. That they manifest yourself to everyone that is hearing my voice, whatever they might be. In the name of Jesus, that they show yourself, manifest your power, manifest your presence. In the name of Jesus, that they manifest your power, manifest your presence. Manifest yourself, oh Lord, in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. We're going to open our mouth and cry loud and clear. Say, every power assigned to hinder our prayers, be paralyzed. In the name of Jesus, every power assigned to hinder our prayers, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Every power, wherever you are coming from, I command it to be paralyzed. Powers in the air, powers on the ground, powers in the covens of darkness assigned to hinder our prayers, I command them to be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Every power assigned to come against our prayers, we command them to be paralyzed, to be paralyzed in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, every power assigned against our prayers today, be paralyzed. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And every one of us, let's cry loud and clear. Say, garments of fresh fire, baptize my life. In the name of Jesus, let the garment of fresh fire baptize my life. In the name of Jesus, garments of the fresh fire, baptize my life. In the name of Jesus, baptize my life, baptize everyone on this prayer line, baptize our family, baptize our home, baptize our Almighty, everyone around us, in the name of Jesus, fire of God, baptize us, that garment of fresh fire, baptize us all, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. And so you will now see this loud and say, every satanic altar assigned against my prayer altar, catch fire in the name of Jesus. Every satanic altar assigned against my prayer altar, catch fire in the name of Jesus. Catch fire in the name of Jesus. Catch fire, catch fire, catch fire, catch fire, catch fire in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, I pray for everyone connected to this prayer line, wherever they might be in the whole world, I ask that you will touch their lives in Jesus' name. I ask that you will, Almighty, uphold them in the name of Jesus. I ask that you will also, Almighty, increase them in the name of Jesus. You will bless them also in the name of Jesus. As, O Lord, they say amen, and as they, Almighty, receiving this prayer, that I decree, let this prayer go into their foundation in the name of Jesus. Let these prayers repair their foundations in the name of Jesus. Let these prayers begin to sort them out of the obscurity in Jesus' name. Let this prayer begin to deliver them in the name of Jesus. Let the miracle in this prayer, let Almighty also, Almighty, locate each and every one in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, I thank you. And so I soak every everyone connected to this prayer line with the blood of Jesus. I remember that listening to me, I cover their homes and their families with the blood. I ask, O Lord Almighty, that you will touch and you will begin a great thing as Almighty we continue in our prayers in Jesus' name. My Father, we thank you. For your word is we should pray without ceasing. Your word is we should pray without ceasing. Daddy, as we open our mouths to pray, we ask, O Lord, that we receive answers in Jesus' name. We receive divine answer in the name of Jesus. We receive divine answer in the name of Jesus. As many that are Almighty heartbroken, that have joined the prayer line, Father, I ask, O Lord Almighty, that you will heal them completely in Jesus' name. As many Almighty that need deliverance, I ask that you will deliver them in the name of Jesus. As many Almighty that need Almighty the yoke to be taken away from them, Father, I ask that you lift up their yokes in the name of Jesus and begin to Almighty touch their destinies in Jesus' name. Father, we glorify you in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. God bless you all for being on this prayer line. And very briefly, I will talk to you about these short topics. And I will target, you shall not be ashamed. I say it again, you shall not be ashamed. I want you to tell yourself three times, I shall not be ashamed three times. Let's go. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible talks in Psalms 25, verse 1, from verse 1. Psalm 25, from verse 1. Psalm 25, from verse 1. It says, unto thee, O Lord, do I lift my soul. O my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. And it says, yea, let none that wait on thee be ashamed. Let them be ashamed which transgress without cause. I pray that no one on this prayer line will be ashamed in Jesus' name. As many that the enemy has programmed shame into for you, I decree that such evil program shall scatter in the name of Jesus. I decree one more time that you shall not be ashamed. In the name of Jesus, you shall not be ashamed. In the name of Jesus, you shall not be ashamed. In the name of Jesus, you shall not be ashamed. In the name of Jesus Christ, as many mighty that are on this prayer line asking God, the Lord, why am I facing this reproach? I decree and I declare that the God whom you serve shall Almighty drag you out of reproach in Jesus' name. And you shall not be ashamed in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, Lord, we thank you. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Now the word of God says in Psalm 25, verse 1 to 3, says, unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. And that's where we sing that song. Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. Oh my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. Amen. Beloved, I pray that any power, any principality, any force from the kingdom of darkness that wants to put it to shame shall be disgraced in the name of Jesus. I say they shall be disgraced in the name of Jesus. I say they shall be disgraced in the name of Jesus. Now, another Bible passage says, Psalms 35, verse 4. Psalms 35, verse 4. Psalms 35, verse 4. It says, let them be confounded and be put to shame that seek after my soul. Let them be turned back and be brought to confusion that divides my heart. I pray for somebody that every shame prepared for you, oh, it shall go back to sender in the name of Jesus. I say it shall go back to sender in the name of Jesus. I say it shall go back to sender in the name of Jesus. Now say to yourself again, I shall not be ashamed. Three times. Let me hear you now. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now listen, this short message is for those that the enemy has put them in a tight corner. It's for those that have tried their best, they have tried ways out, but they could not get away. It's for those that the enemy consistently and continually put to shame, to the extent sometimes it looks like they are asking, where is your God? It's for those that the enemy has actually disgraced. It's for those that the enemy has discredited and dishonored, and those that the enemy has poured reproach on. I pray for you that the agenda of shame that has been programmed for you or for members of your family, I command that agenda to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter. In the name of Jesus, let's say it again three more times. I shall not be ashamed. Three times, let me hear you. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not be ashamed in the name of Jesus. Beloved, I know a God of all flesh. I know a God that answers by fire. I know a God that does not fail. I know a God that is ready to bring rejoicing. I know a God that is ready to mighty to bring mighty great things into your life. I know a God that can remove shame. And I pray that if the enemy has put shame on you, innocently, or whichever way you have acquired shame, I command, let that shame scatter in the name of Jesus. And let your life begin to see celebration. Let your life begin to experience rejoicing. Let your life begin to move forward in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible also says in Isaiah 61 verse 7, Isaiah 61 verse 7 says, for your shame ye shall have double, and for confusion they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore in their land they shall possess the double. Everlasting joy shall be unto them. I pray for somebody here. You have been ashamed. It seems you have been disgraced. But the Bible says, according to the word of God in Isaiah 61 verse 7, says, for your shame, you shall receive double. For your shame, you shall receive double. For your shame, you shall receive double. You shall receive double in the name of Jesus. I say you shall receive double in the name of Jesus. And I decree that everlasting joy shall be your portion. Everlasting joy shall be your portion. Everlasting joy shall be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, I want to talk to you that as many that the enemy has put to shame, there is a God that can honor you. There is a God that can bring rejoicing again. There is a God that can lift up your head. I pray that if you have been put to shame, wherever you have been put to shame, I ask, let the hand of God begin to bring mighty rejoicing into your home. Let the hand of God begin to honor you again. Let the hand of God begin to pull you out of almighty, of shame in the name of Jesus. And I ask that the Lord will fight your battles in Jesus' name. Listen, in the Bible, there are very many people that went into shame. It was as if that they were going to be put to shame. Daniel was put to shame at a time when they put him into shame, into the lion's den. It was like a shame. Yes, they caught him. They held him. They said, yes, you are praying when we say we should not pay. Now, let's go and put you in the den. He was kept in the lion's den. We thank God that God did not allow the lions to tear him into pieces. And he came out alive. I pray for somebody on this prayer line that even though the enemy thinks that you are finished, I declare that you are not finished. I say you are not finished. I say you are not finished. I say you are not finished. God is yet to start with you. God is yet to start with you. It will give you what I call everlasting joy. Your enemies shall see it. They shall also rejoice with you. Your enemies will not die, but they will see you rejoicing. They want to put you to shame. For that shame, you shall receive double. I say you shall receive double in the name of Jesus. I say you shall receive double. I say you shall receive double. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. It says, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. I want to tell you, even as they crucified Jesus Christ, and it was as if they put him to shame. But we know that on the third day, he rose up again. Jesus rose up again. If Jesus rose up again, you are rising up again. I say you are rising out of your shame. You are rising out of your shame. I decree into your life that you are rising out of your shame. In the name of Jesus, it does not matter how long you have been in it. The God you serve will drag you out of that shame, and he will bring you, Almighty, into a palace of rejoicing. It will bring you into everlasting rejoicing. It will bring you to everlasting joy in the name of Jesus. It is a season of favor for you. Where you have been put to shame, the Lord God whom you serve, he will Almighty favor you there. He will favor you there. He will give you Almighty favor. He will let your glory to shine in the name of Jesus Christ. And I say, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Don't forget that. Looking unto Jesus. As many that are here, the enemy has held you down. It seems that nothing can come out. It seems that there's no way out. It seems that the marriage is scattered. It seems that the marriage has been, Almighty, has been turned upside down. It seems that, Almighty, even your home, there is nothing happening there. The Lord God Almighty is talking to you. You shall not be put to shame. I say you shall not be put to shame. I speak to somebody, you are currently begging right now. But the Lord God Almighty says you are in for a surprise. I say he says you are in for a surprise. You are in for a surprise. A super enlargement. You are begging right now. You know yourself. You are on this prayer line. It is a season for you now. The season that is coming will be a season of multiplication. A season of great things. A season of enlargement. And those that are laughing at you right now, they shall celebrate with you. In fact, they shall plan your celebration. And yes, rejoicing shall come back into your home. In the name of Jesus. And so I speak to someone here. That as many of you that are going through a shameful situation, the Lord and the Word of God is talking to you right now that you are going to rise again. I say you are going to rise again. I say you are going to rise again. I say you are rising again. I decree into your life, you are rising again. In the name of Jesus Christ, I say you are rising again. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Word of God is settled. The Word of God is clear. The Word of God says clearly in his Word, listen, my brother, listen, my sister, because I know a God that can do all things. I know a God that can do all things. I know a God that can do all things. I know a God that can fight your battles. I know a God that can do great and mighty things. I know a God who is not partial. He is ready and willing to walk in every area of your life. He is ready and willing to do great and mighty things for you. And I pray that our God will fight your battles in Jesus' mighty name. The Word of God is clear. It is, for we walk in the flesh. We do not war after the flesh. And we need to begin to ask the Lord that the Lord God Almighty will begin to drag us from where we are right now into a place of rejoicing, into our palace, Almighty, of joy, in the name of Jesus. The Word of God is clear, and the Word of God is Almighty sharper than any two-edged sword. As many that are going through right now, I pray for you that shame in your life is vanished in the name of Jesus. The shame in your family is vanished in the name of Jesus. The shame among the children is vanished in the name of Jesus. Anything bringing shame, whatever is bringing shame into your life, whatever is bringing shame into your business, whatever is making you to be ashamed, and you can't even share with anybody, I ask the God of Elijah, I ask the miracle working God, I ask the God Almighty that can turn things around. I ask that God should begin a great thing in your life in Jesus' name. The God that created the whole world in 7 days, I say let that God begin to create a new thing in your life in the name of Jesus. The Word of God says, let me not be ashamed, O Lord, for I have called upon thee. Let the wicked be ashamed, and let them be silent in the grave. Psalm 31, verse 17. And so I decree that whoever has poured the water of shame on you, whoever has come to you and decreed and cursed you, the shame has continue to walk in your life, I decree, let the Word of God clear away every curse of shame. Let the word of God begin to wash them away. Let the word of God begin to clear it away. Let the blood of Jesus begin to wash them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Everybody, wherever you are, put your right hand on your head and say this after me. Say, every reproach of shame in my life, die in the name of Jesus. All the reproach of shame in my life, die, 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 die in the name of Jesus. All the reproach of shame in my life, die, 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 in the name of Jesus Christ. You put your right hand against your head and you will say this loud and clear. Say, I shall not be ashamed 7 times. In the name of, let's say it again. I shall not be ashamed. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. You will not put your hands down. I want to believe that you are listening and you are praying wherever you are. Say, power of God, destroy the shame in my life. Power of God, destroy the shame in my life. In the name of Jesus. Power of God, destroy the shame in my life. In the name of Jesus, let the power of God open your mouth and pray. Power of God, destroy shame in my life. In the name of Jesus, every shame in my life, power of God, destroy them. Power of God, destroy them. Power of God, destroy them. Power of God, destroy them now. In Jesus' name, they are destroyed. Everybody, you will say this loud and clear. Say, every power assigned to put shame upon my life, you say, die with your shame. In the name of Jesus, every power assigned to put shame upon my life, die with your shame. In the name of Jesus, die with your shame. In the name of Jesus, die with your shame. Die with your shame. In the name of Jesus, die with your shame. In the name of Jesus, die with your shame. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're now going to cry loud and clear. Now you know that God himself does not want an agenda of shame for his children. He doesn't want his children to be ashamed. And so I know our God that says that you cannot be ashamed. You cannot be ashamed. You now cry loud and clear. Say, oh God of Elijah, drag me out of my shame. In the name of Jesus, oh God of Elijah, drag me out of my shame. In the name of Jesus, drag me out of my shame. In the name of Jesus, oh God of Elijah, drag me out of my shame. Drag me out of my shame. Drag me out of my shame. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Everybody, let's cry loud and clear to the Almighty God. Say, owners of the load of shame and disgrace in my life, appear, carry your load. In the name of Jesus, owners of the load of shame and disgrace in my life, appear, carry your load, appear, carry your load, appear, carry your load. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You're not going to say this loud and clear. Any power anywhere assigned to tie me to shame, any power anywhere assigned to tie me to shame, release me and die. In the name of Jesus, any power anywhere assigned to tie me to shame, release me and die. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And so I want to tell you, shame is a devourer. It's a devourer of labor. You can gather and gather and gather. Shame can come there and come and devoid. I pray that every way that shame has destroyed anyone on this prayer line, Father, let there be a repair. Let there be a repair. Father, let there be a repair. In the name of Jesus, let there be a repair. In the name of Jesus, let there be a repair. In the name of Jesus, let there be a repair. Let there be a repair. Let there be a reply. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to open your mouth and say it loud and clear. The Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, he moves around as a roaring lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8, he's looking about walking and moving around like a lion, seeking whom he may devour. You will shout it loud and clear. See, every satanic altar assigned against my prayer altar, catch fire in the name of Jesus. Satanic altar assigned against my prayer altar, catch fire in the name of Jesus. Catch fire, 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 in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we thank you. We bless your name. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We say there is none like unto thee. Blessed be the name. Glory be unto you, Lord. Hallowed be thy name, Jehovah. I pray for everyone on this prayer line who has been going through shame. I ask, oh Lord, that you will begin to fight for them in Jesus' name. And I decree that every association anointed to laugh you to scorn, I command that association to scatter in the name of Jesus. Every association anointed to disgrace you, I command them to scatter in the name of Jesus. Every evil association anointed to embarrass you, I command them to scatter in the name of Jesus. Every evil association anointed to mock you, I command that power to scatter in the name of Jesus. Every evil association anointed to laugh you to scorn, I command them to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter. In the name of Jesus, every evil association wishing evil for you, all that are wishing you dead, that are evil wishing you evil, I command them to scatter by fire, to scatter by fire, in the name of Jesus. And I begin to fire back every arrow of shame that has been fired against you. I fire back in Jesus' name. I fire back, I fire back, I fire back, I fire back, in the name of Jesus. Every dick pit has been dug for you by the enemy, I decree, let it begin to swallow the enemy in the name of Jesus. Let it begin to swallow them. Let it begin to swallow them in the name of Jesus. Let it begin to swallow them. I decree and I declare that every intelligent enemy assigned to pull you down, I command that enemy to die in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been done, oh Lord, I ask that has gone wrong in your life, whatever has gone wrong and has been damaged, tell the Lord, and I decree, as many things that have been damaged, I speak on your behalf, that let there be a repair in the name of Jesus. Let there be a repair. Let there be a repair. Let there be a repair in the name of Jesus. Every voice speaking against your destiny, I command them to shut up by fire in the name of Jesus. Any power summoning you from the gate of death, I silence them in the name of Jesus. And I declare that every coven decision, every coven judgment, every coven pronouncement, I command them to crush in the name of Jesus. Every coven pronouncement over my life, over everyone on this prayer line, I say let that coven catch fire and let those pronouncements crush to pieces in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray for your children again. There's many already that are already ready to receive the baptism of fire. Daddy, I ask Lord, release your fresh fire upon them. Release your fresh fire upon them. Release your fresh fire upon them. In the name of Jesus Christ. And I decree that for your shame, you shall receive double. You shall receive double. You shall receive double. I say you shall receive double. I say you shall receive double. Where they have disgraced you, you can go back there and you shall be accepted in the name of Jesus. And I decree that every strong man operating to naked you, I command them to die in the name of Jesus. To die in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, I worship your name. I cover everyone on the prayer line with the blood of Jesus. They have heard the word, oh Lord, today. They have heard Almighty. I ask that the Almighty turn around for good in the name of Jesus. And also the Almighty begin to experience Almighty honor in the name of Jesus. In their judgment, honor. Oh Lord, I ask that you increase them in the name of Jesus Christ. Ah Lord, I bless you. Ah Lord, I give you praise. Lord, I give you all the glory. Ah, we worship your name. I give you all the adoration. It is by only you, oh Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord. We worship and bless your name. I give you praise. Thank you for your love upon everyone on this prayer line. And I begin to speak into your home that the Lord God Almighty will repair your home. Whatever damage has been done, let there be a repair in your home. Let there be a repair in your home. Let there be a repair in your home in the name of Jesus. I decree again that as many that might the enemy has marked down for death this year, I cancel it. I cancel. I cancel them in the name of Jesus. I cancel them in the name of Jesus. I cancel them in the, by the power in the blood of Jesus. I decree that you shall not be disgraced again. You shall not be disgraced. Rather than disgrace, the Lord will give you grace. You shall, how many, be honored. Anywhere they have dishonored you, you shall be honored. You shall not be discredited again. There will be no reproach in your life because God has determined to bless you, and you shall be blessed in the name of Jesus. I say you shall be blessed in the name of Jesus. And I know even when they gather against you, the Lord has said it. Where they gather against you, that he will stand for you, and they shall scatter for your sake. I decree that every satanic platform that the enemy is standing on in order to attack you, I pull them down in the name of Jesus. I pull them down in the name of Jesus. I pull them down in the name of Jesus Christ. King of glory, thank you. Ancient of Days will bless your name. I am that I am, we worship you. Thank you for everyone on this prayer line. And I worship your name because you are a God that answers prayers. To you all be all the glory. To you Almighty be all the honor. Glory be unto you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And I pray for all the children out there. I ask that the Lord Almighty will protect all our children in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you for joining the prayer line. Beloved, make sure that you are inviting all your friends, and the Lord will begin to bless you in return in the name of Jesus. God bless you for joining the prayer line, and the Lord will strengthen you. God bless you. Bye.